I think this is like a super health. Eh, well, not a super health, just a full heal. All right, star cannon, I think. See what we got. The Fallen Knight. Okay, so he just throws the heat-seeking things as well. And summons the undead. Fair. I can respect some good old-fashioned necromancy. I don't like it, but I can respect it. Alright, where is he lurking? I have rockets for him. Woo! Oh, he's got like... Oh, there's like skeletal hands coming out of the ground and shit. That's really cool. I was wondering what that noise was. Maybe this is like sacrifices to the boss to give him power or some bullshit. I don't know. I'm not gonna think about it. Okay, so how does this... Oh, is it like if I'm just like... I'm gonna figure out how these, like, hands on the ground, what do these do? Oh, it's just the undead, okay. So it's nothing, like, crazy or anything. Another boss, though, that it looks as though the shotgun, or not the shotgun, the rocket launcher is gonna be kind of our primary workhorse here. I really like that all of the bosses have thus far been, like, fairly different from each other. Like, none of them, like, mechanically, I should say, they're fairly different. I mean, they all throw projectiles, but, like, there's more to the fights than just, hey, it's a dude with a gun or a rocket launcher. Like, there's mechanics to it beyond just whatever armaments they may have. I feel like I should maybe save, especially when I'm rocketing myself like a dope. Well, there's my rockets, except I was gonna say that there's a bunch more in here. There's a lot of zombies, skeletons, undead. So I can't tell if this is like a fight where we have to like kill him before we're overwhelmed, or if there's a finite amount of the undead that are gonna pop up, or what. Or if we can, in fact, just circle straight to victory. Here, I wanna grab these. I wouldn't mind if they perhaps added a boss health bar. That could be nice. Maybe a little too gamey, though. I don't know. Go ahead and save again. Alright, where is he? Oh, there we go. We got him. I would honestly say that this guy was substantially easier than the last boss. Like, he's just a horde boss. Which one is the toughest? Probably the guy before this one that would, like, always knock you off of platforms and stuff. His was purely difficult because of, like, the water jet that he would spray on you that would send you flying off into the depths. The depths, rather. He's, I think, the boss that I died the most on. And then the only other one I think we fought is one that was basically, like, a Hell Knight that flew. Or a Baron that flew. He wasn't too bad. It was just circle strafe to victory. A boss health bar in a Doom game? Like, that's like heretical. And we don't even talk about Doom 2016. Ah, well, we're out of there. So we have a forest, it looks like. And then maybe like some Iceland. All right, so we're going into like Iceland, and then it's gonna be like Castle Land. I don't know. And then there's a bridge. Oh, that looks like a little city over there. That's adorable. All right. What time is it? 4:50. Yeah, we probably got another level or two. Castlevania. That looks kind of janky. The fuck is that? A little mole. Is that like a Monty mole or something? I don't even know, but it throws things at me and I can't kill it. But we can, however, frolic amongst the butterflies. Oh shit, Cacodemon. Where'd you come from? I was frolicking. Nine health. We've entered the comfort zone. Where is he? I hear him, but I don't see him. Okay. Whoa! I was like, what was that noise? And there's two of these fuckers just standing here. And I'm like, where are they? Derp, derp. Yeah, I don't like these things. I don't like enemies in games that make you have to wait to kill them. It's one of the reasons I've kind of fallen off of Path of Exile so hard. Grinding Gear Games has gone, like, a little bit too deep into the bosses with fucking minute-long invulnerability phases for my tastes. Regular imps, I know, right? And there was a pinky back there, too. What in the fresh hell is this? Oh my god, those are giant flowers upon which rests an imp. It was worth it! Okay, but seriously though, what just killed me? I have no idea. Well, that's trouble. Fucking bees just floating around out there waiting to strike. Alright. Like, it would be one thing if it were an invulnerability phase, like for the boss transforming or whatever, that's like, you know, 5 seconds long, but they're like going like full stupidity with it, and I just can't. I just can't. I know you're lurking around the corner, you fucking goddamn it. Fucking mancubus. Where did the- I didn't even see that one back there, yeah. Okay, quick save. So... Oh, don't tell me I gotta- there's no way. Oh, this is terrible. It's terrible. Alright. Oh, no. Oh, this sucks. I don't like this at all. This is the opposite of bueno. This is like super no bueno. Like, I'm standing on this platform completely exposed, and I have a fucking Hell Knight I need to deal with. Ooh. Oh, flinch chance just saved my ass. Okay, let's go ahead and save. Yeah, like, I understand the why of them going with the invulnerability phases. Like, they want players to actually experience the boss fight instead of just, like, deleting it. But... I don't know. How they're going around, how they're going about it fucking sucks. And it's partially their own fault because they refuse to dial back the gotta go fast gameplay. That's one thing that I really hope that they do with Path of Exile 2.0 is that they're like, yeah, we're going back to being like a reasonably paced game now. You can't like kill monsters two screens away anymore, which of course the fan base will fucking revolt against because the game is like gotta go fast incarnate now, and it just it pisses me off because I really like the game. It's just I just don't like how they're designing around like this ridiculous playstyle. Ridiculous as far as I'm concerned anyways. Oh no, I don't disagree. They have put themselves in a corner of their own making. It just makes me sad. Because they're doing stuff like blanket increasing boss HP and whatnot to, you know, so that they actually are a speed bump of some sort, and even then they're still not a speed bump to like the people that are playing your Flavor of the Month builds or whatever, and so it just like screws the people that aren't playing Flavor of the Month builds out of, you know, having a decent time with things. Like, if you want to design top-end content around that, that's one thing, but like I've heard that just running like through the act bosses are just supremely difficult now compared to how they used to be and stuff. I don't know. What game? Path of Exile. I want this coin, but I don't know where we're supposed to go. I hit that. Oh, that's right. There's a whole other path at the very beginning. I think what we have to do to get this is just run. Yep. Oh, we do, but we have to run at an angle like this. And we also have to stop, apparently. Well, in that case, fuck you, game. I do what I want. There we go. Yeah, the air control in this is pretty good. Alright, so we want to backtrack. So here's where we came in, so we haven't been this way. They're being a little stingy with the health, I have to say. Can I destroy this? Seriously? Oh, you teases! Not recently, no. Like, Fiancé game is basically done. I have been incredibly lax in updating my blog, but the game is basically done. I just need to finish, like, polishing some things and, like, plugging in an area's worth of monsters and getting the final boss fight put together, and then that's finished. My goal is to get it to her for her birthday this year, which, considering that the amount of work that's left in it is like maybe 15 to 20 hours worth of stuff, if that, should be more than doable. Yeah, like I think Grim Dawn is about the speed that I'm comfortable with. Like you can go reasonably quick in it, but you can still, you know, I don't want to say you can see what's going on because that game's got shit flying everywhere, just as bad as Path of Exile, but yeah. Grim Dawn, I think, sets a good pace for what I'm looking for from an action RPG. You motherfucking sniff it! You little fuck, I'm going to just rock your world with rockets. Whoop. Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, I agree with that. I think of all of the action RPGs of, I guess, this generation, I don't know what you would call it, I think Diablo has the best play feel of all of them. Probably followed by probably followed by, I would say, Grim Dawn. Path of Exile feels okay once you get, like, higher level. But the early game kind of sucks, but... yeah. Diablo felt good to play. Diablo 3 did. Absolutely. Ooh! It just completely failed with regards to being not really as... It was about as deep as a puddle, and I want more than that. Like, I would almost say that Grim Dawn is too deep, but it's really not. It's... I think my problem with a lot of Grim Dawn's depth is that it's mostly depth by obscurity. Or not Grim Dawn, Path of Exile, rather. Grim Dawn is, I would say, just deep enough for me. Like, I like my crunchy games, but Path of Exile asks a lot of you. Again, though, it asks a lot of you if you want, like, top-end builds, which... oh... which now you need. The Skyrim of action RPGs. I wouldn't say that, because Diablo 3 is satisfying to play. God damn it. Yeah, that's another one that kills me, and I think, like, Grim Dawn probably wins out in that. Like, that game, you can zoom out so far, it's wonderful. Where is that fucker? There he is. Alright, I was wondering where that thing was. Alright, you little shit. Oh. Oh. I think that got him. Ha ha! Did I? Yeah, he's dead. Can't tell if I'm hitting? I am. 5 health left. We got this. Easy. God damn it, it's the jumps. It's the jumps, the terror. Oh, there we go. Butterflies, I could really use some health right about now. Throw me a bone, please. When are all else, like, people see the same for Diablo 4, with regards to what, like it not being... yeah, with regards to what? Because, like, from the gameplay I've seen of Diablo 4, it seems like it's going to be even further simplified from Diablo 3, which... like, if they want to go that direction, I don't think there's... I don't have a problem if they want to make the game simple, it's just, I'm not going to play it. Like, I don't mind playing simpler games, it's just, ooh. I want more than that out of Diablo. No, fuck bees! Jesus. Yeah, I want that. Then I assume that we have to cross that. I think there's a super heal. No, just a regular one. I'll take it. Back into the blessed double digits of health. Like, the thing that kills me is that, like, Diablo 3, if it weren't called Diablo 3, I have a feeling a lot of people would look back on it a lot more fondly. Well, I shouldn't say that. If it weren't called Diablo 3 and Reaper of Souls were the first initial release, I think people would look back upon it a lot more fondly. That's what I thought that did. But, yeah. Well, with regards to the flying and stuff, that was taken out due to console limitations. As far as I understand. Which, I mean, I don't disagree that it's dumbed down by comparison to Morrowind, and player choice has been, you know, kicked solidly in the groin, but at the same time... don't feel like you missed much by not playing 3. I mean, you're not wrong. Like, there's really... storyline-wise, you're not missing anything. It's got the worst story of all of them by a long shot. Gameplay-wise, it's a fun game to play. Honestly, if you were to play it, I would recommend actually picking up a console copy. That game plays wonderfully on a controller. I would say almost better than PC, but then you miss out on updates and stuff, and it's a pain in the ass. Many games are like that. Fallout 4 and Fable 3 are good games. They just aren't good games in those series. Exactly! Exactly! And I think that's the thing, though, is that, like, the developers are cashing in on the name, and because of it, they then reap, you know, fan rage. But yeah, if Fallout 4 weren't a Fallout game, I'd just be like, it's a shooter that plays pretty decently and has a really shit story. Instead, I can be vitriolic about it for a long time if I really want to. So yeah, no, you're totally right on that. I don't care why it was removed, you still hate it. Oh, I don't blame you. I think it's shit. And it's something that I'm absolutely positive Bethesda is going to keep up with each additional release in the series. They're just going to keep pulling stuff out. Because that's what Todd Howard likes to do. He likes, air quotes, streamlining his games. And that's what you get when you streamline things. But yeah, I absolutely agree that it is a lessened experience. A lessened experience, I should say. Because of things being pulled out of it. Because, like, you could get up to so much shit in Morrowind, it was great. That looks like something. Is that something? No. Alright. Maybe. Maybe? I don't know. No. No, it is not. Okay. When you say dated, what do you mean? Like, how does it feel dated? Like, as in, like, the combat doesn't handle great? Because that's a complaint that I would agree with you on. Most of my love of Morrowind is just all of the shit that it lets you get up to. Oh, Firefall! We haven't seen one of these things in ages! The thing that I like most about Morrowind is that the game, it gives you the tools, and it's just like, here, figure shit out. Like, go do whatever you want. You can break our game, we're okay with that. And with each subsequent release from there, they're like, no, we're gonna tighten the reins a little bit, and now they, like, don't let you even make your own spells anymore. Clunky and awkward. Again, I can see that on the combat side of things, absolutely. I don't know if I would say I would agree with that with regards to, like, movement and stuff, because I think it controls pretty similarly to, like, Oblivion. At least Oblivion, maybe Skyrim. Skyrim did have some improvements to the movement and whatnot, but I don't know. Yeah, getting rid of the spell creation was not a good choice. I understand why they did it, because the spell system in Skyrim is so different from every game beforehand, but it still sucks. Of course there's a spellcrafting mod for Skyrim. One thing that I do want to do, and I'll probably stream it because I don't know that I would want to make it a Let's Play, I actually want to play Enderal. Like that total fan conversion mod that those dudes made. I've heard it's really good. So that will probably be an eventually, maybe this year. Yeah, that's kind of how I look at it too, Marble. Like, there's nothing wrong with making things, like, there's nothing wrong necessarily with streamlining something. There are some, like, things in older games that are fucking clunky and, like, not having tooltips, you know? But at the same time, when you're just, like, removing things, especially under the guise of, well, it makes things simpler for the player, it's like, come on, don't treat your players like they're idiots. But I don't know. Like, I'm sure that there are beam counters, and they have decided that mathematically, if you get rid of this stuff, people will still buy this game by the bajillions, and yeah, like, exactly. Mouse aiming for sure. Fucking the best Elder Scrolls is Blades. Oh. I actually never played it. I can't speak to its quality or lack thereof. Whoop! Oh, we killed him. Alright. Seriously? There's some beefy Hell Knights up here. You may die at any time, sir. Thank you. Yeah, exactly. Like, I'm okay with that. I'm okay with them adding things to, like, make the thing more smooth. Like, yeah, like, quest waypoints, for example. Totally fine. I don't care. It doesn't bother me, especially if you can disable them in the options. Stuff like fast travel. Sure, why not? You know, I don't have infinite free time anymore. I appreciate things that save me time, but at the same time, I don't necessarily always want to use them or always, you know, have my hand held. Hated Wind Waker. I'm not a fan of basically any of the three-dimensional Zeldas. I much more enjoy the old 2D ones. Oh, we're just noping out of that one. Wind Waker is actually one of the few 3D ones that I didn't have a terrible time with. Wind Waker and Breath of the Wild are the only 3D ones that I've played, and I can look back and I'm like, yeah, I had an okay time with those. Well, yeah, exactly, Mumble. Like, I completely agree with that. It's like, there's something to say for a market towards people who like games that have got a lot of meat on the bones, like, if you really want to dig in. Stuff like Path of Exile, where, you know, if you want to, you can theorycraft a build out, and it, you know, might take you days or weeks to figure out a really good combo, and it rewards that, and I'm totally cool with that. Sadly, though, that is not the way most game devs go these days. Like, I like my really crunchy RPGs. Sadly, though, most aim for the Diablo 3 way of doing things. There was a mobile Elder Scrolls game, yeah. I remember it got released, everybody shat on it, and I haven't heard anything about it since. Exactly, Marble. Like, that's another thing, is that, like, if your game requires a bunch of investment, then yeah. It's like Let's Playing, you know? People like shorter... Ooh, that's a new gun. People like shorter Let's Plays because you can get in, watch it, and be done in, like, you know, 4 episodes or whatever, right? Where somebody's gonna see something that's, like, 60 episodes long and think to themselves, do I want to dedicate 30 hours of my life to this? Please be a flamethrower. Sniper rifle? Oh my god, it has a heart. A Cupid drum mag. I know, Ela, it's surprising, isn't it? You'd never guess. I was just bitching earlier, wanting something with a... How does it work? Alright! Oh wow, that thing does some damage. Can I shoot it? So it's like a fucking railgun. Oh, this game. Yeah, see, that's how I look at it too, Cap. Is that I am a huge fan of long-form Let's Plays. Use the Cupid Mark V scope to snipe enemies far away from you. Game, I already figured that out. I had that figured out within a second of picking it up. My aim, however... Where you going, buddy? Oh, won't one-shot a Baron, though. Won't two-shot a Baron. Shit. Alright, fair enough. Better it has an effective range. Okay, where am I going? Over here. So what is that? 7? That is in fact 7. So is this is like our BFG, right? What? Oh, I hear one of those little... Oh, hey. I like this thing a lot, but I think I need to probably be more careful with my ammo expenditures. Nope! Fucking reload! Ooh! Let's kill ourselves with a rocket launcher. The game, the movie, the miniseries. Alright, oh, that's death. Almost. But the game that the Game Freak's A-team is working on is way too complicated. Everyone's giving it poor reviews because it's confusing. What? I don't even know what you're talking about. Little Town Hero. Yeah, I've never heard of that one. I like complicated, though. Let's see what this is.